Hey Rushers, this is Chester Gregory from Sister Act, and you're watching Stage Rush TV. Stay tuned.
What's going on, Rushers? Welcome back to Stage Rush TV. This week, I am co-hosting with Adam Rothenberg, who hosts Adaumbelle's Quest. Adam, thank you so much for being on Stage Rush TV.
Thanks for having me,
I love it. On Adaumbelle's Quest, you can find great interviews that Adam does with people like Hugh Panero and Jan Maxwell and even Olivia Newton-John.
Yes.
That's pretty awesome.
Yes.
Adam and I just came from Broadway and Bryant Park. I think this is the fourth week.
Yeah.
And, you know, Hugh Panero was there. Performing for Phantom of the Opera. Mm-hmm. He was really great.
He was amazing.
He's one of my favorite performers. He's a Temple alumni.
Yeah.
And for all the years that probably always remember where I went to Scott College, I went to Temple as well. So he's a fellow owl. It's really, really neat. He sang Music of the Night. Mm-hmm. He did a really good job.
He did.
Really great.
He's such a big, beautiful voice that, like, I just love. He could sing anything and I would just be like, in heaven.
Turn your face away from the garish light of day. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light, and listen to the music of the night.
And I was, of course, you know, this is my platform for Broadway and Bryant Park. I was really glad to see him there today, because he's like a big A-list star on Broadway, and I was glad that he showed up and didn't send his understudy.
Yes.
Which is Jeremy Stoll, by the way, who we love here at Stage Rush, so I wouldn't have minded seeing Jeremy Stoll. I'm sure he wouldn't have minded either. But it was great to see you.
I'm very glad that he was there, because
good old Hugh.
He's amazing and nice and wonderful.
Who else was great today? Oh, Matt Lysy was there for performing with the Fantastics, which was awesome because Matt has been on Stage Rush before, which is awesome. So we love that.
This is actually my first time at Broadway and Bryant.
Your first experience with that. How was it?
It was great. I mean, out of all the years I lived in New York, I've never gone, and I'm so thrilled that I was able to go today. And it's a great experience. You get a nice sampling of like four or five shows, and they're terrific. The cast are great, and you get a great sampling, and it really, I think, excites you to want to go see the show and go see a Broadway show.
And you were very lucky. You got a very, I guess for July in New York City, mild day. It was fairly mild.
Yes.
It was clouds.
Yeah.
Red. You were good. So you enjoyed your first experience.
Oh, I loved it. I mean, we saw Hair.
Hair was great.
The cast of Hair, they were great.
They were good.
They're on tour right now, but they have made a Broadway stop till September 10th, and they're terrific. It's a great cast, and some of the original Broadway Revival cast members are in there, and it's wonderful.
Casey Sheik was not there today.
No, she was not.
Yeah. And we would be remiss to not mention Steele Burkhart, who the Mick from The Craptacular kind of loves, but he was there today.
Yes.
Look at all manly. You know who was one of my favorite performers today? The Traces.
Oh my god, they were amazing.
It's kind of Cirque du Soleil-ish. You know, it's one of those, it's always, like, every week there's like a show that's not like a typical, not a play that performs, and sometimes it doesn't always translate. They did fantastic.
Yeah.
They did this wonderful romantic expressionistic dance between this guy and girl. They were both very, very sexy themselves.
Yes, and they were lifting her up in the air and
throwing her all over the place.
Very Cirque du Soleil with the acrobatics and the use of the next guy who performed, he was in like
hoop.
He
took hula hooping to a new level, didn't he?
A huge level.
Feeling conscious like help is first. Set a prayer that's sincere when you felt it work. Times I feel I want to shout, but it's real that way. When I think of things that make you feel that way. Feel that way.
Yeah, it was like,
it was great.
He was rolling around the stage inside the hoop, and
How does he not break his fingers? That's why he's doing it, and I'm doing this.
Right.
I love that. And they really made it translate to the stage with those props and the pop. I love that. Also, just something that stuck out to me, I don't know if you felt this way, this was a very attractive day at Broadway at Bryant Park.
Yeah.
There were some very attractive onstage couples, Paris Remillard and Karen Lynn Tackett from Hair.
Yes.
They look great.
Yes.
And also Laura Osnes and Colin O'Donnell from Anything Goes. What a striking couple they are. I mean, onstage couple. They look great.
Right.
I interviewed someone this week who has been, ever since I moved to New York, actually, in 2008, May of 2008, one of my favorite Broadway performers, Chester Gregory, who is now in Sister Act.
So great.
I really love him, and we had a great interview about his road becoming a Broadway mainstay, because he's done so many Broadway shows, these great principal roles. Anyway, you should check out the full interview with him on Stage Rush, but we did one of my favorite segments with him called Word Association, where he gives us his thoughts on some of his most popular projects he's done, so check that out.
Josh Strickland, I love Josh. Josh is amazing, and we had the best time doing that show. That year was just so pivotal in everybody's career. And so just getting the chance to spend that time with Josh and work with him a lot and play his best friend and often be his best friend was a great experience. Ali Mazzi.
What about her?
Ali Mazzi is a comedic genius. And I'm like, she, I'll get behind her and say that to anybody in a minute. It's only a matter of time before people see her in something and she really gets the credit she deserves. The work that she did with Crybaby, not only that, but she was there when I started Hairspray and she had one line, and the line was two words, 9 months. And it was my favorite part in the show. And it was my favorite part in the show because of all she was able to layer into it. And then we got a chance to play opposite one another because I actually did the tour of Hairspray too for 3 weeks in Chicago. I got a chance to premiere it there. And Allie played Penny. And so I got to play Seaweed against, you know, with her. And I was amazed. Shrek. Bryant.
D'Arcy James.
Bryant D'Arcy James, yeah.
What about him?
Bryant D'Arcy James is one of the most amazing people I've ever met and worked with in my life. He's the kindest person. He's sincere. He's tremendously talented, an amazing actor, an amazing singer, an amazing performer. He was light throughout that entire experience. And so I'm very thankful to get a chance to work with him and be able to call him friend.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dreamgirls. Jimmy Early was probably the most fun I've had on stage, probably aside from the Jackie Wilson story, because I got a chance to sort of add little Jackie Wilson sprinkles into this little James Brown, Little Richard kind of interpretation of Jimmy Early I did. So that was a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a lot of room to sort of like play within the realm of the show, of course, but I got a chance to like to really to interact with the audience and bust at them, scream at them, whatever, just have a whole lot of fun. And so, Jimmy Early was a lot of fun.
That was great.
Sister Act, Whoopi Goldberg.
What possibly about Whoopi?
She is an icon. I love how not only tremendously talented she is, but how she gives back to the community. You know, she took a film and now she produced the stage production, and she has provided jobs and opportunities for, you know, for people of color. And, you know, I really love Sister Act because you have, you know, this image of Patina. You have an image of a black female actress on Broadway. She's the lead, and it's her actual face and image as the logo for the show. And, you know, you don't see that often at all. You'll see, like, half of a person's face or, like, the character or something, but, like, her face is on top of Times Square.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's huge. And I think it's very inspirational for not only people of color, but for everyone. Just see a little bit of color on the Great White Way.
So Adam, that was my excitement this week. You've done some pretty cool events this week too.
Yeah, oh my gosh, a lot has been happening. I went to New Fest, which is the Gay, Lesbian, Bisexual, Transgender Film Festival at SVA, and I got to see this great new documentary called One Night Stand, where they chronicled the 24-hour musicals that take place. It's a benefit.
I've heard about those. Those are crazy.
It's crazy. They go from, within 24-hour period, they go from a blank page to a production. They produce 4 15-minute musicals. The documentary was made by Elizabeth Sperling and Trish Dalton. Elizabeth Sperling's brother is Ted Sperling, the musical director who won the Tony Award for Light in the Piazza.
Kevin Daly is a huge, huge fan of Light in the Piazza.
Yes, and it was great. It was a great documentary, and it's hopefully going to go on to other film festivals and a wider release. And some of the Broadway people in the film are Cheyenne Jackson.
Who did you see at this event?
I got to see Cheyenne Jackson.
That's cool.
Always delightful and enjoyable. Mandy Gonzalez from Wicked and In the Heights.
She's great. She's
such
a great voice. Yes. Big belter.
Big,
she's great.
Big belter. Nellie McKay, who was in Three Penny Opera a few years ago. Michael Longoria from Jersey Boys.
I saw him. He was the Frankie Valli when I saw Jersey Boys.
He was terrific. And Capathia Jenkins, big, beautiful Broadway star. She's also on Law & Order.
Yeah.
And Ted Sperling, who was there as well. And I got to interview them all, and the interviews will be coming in the next few
weeks. Awesome. We look forward to that.
Yeah.
That was fun. So awkward. We're moving on to some Broadway grosses. Why don't you kick us off, Adam?
All right. Anything Goes, full capacity in a little bit, 100.6%.
It's so high that we can't even say.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
It's a hot ticket.
So you guess you can't even get into that show.
No,
that's disappointing. Glad we saw a little bit of it at Bryant Park today, which no Sutton Foster, by the way. But
no, she didn't make it.
No,
but
I wasn't surprised.
But it's a great show. I'm sure you.
I haven't seen it. I'd love to.
Oh, yeah, you definitely should see it. I think everyone should. It's a fun show. It's upbeat,
yeah.
And Mary Poppins still going strong at 93%.
They're definitely getting, you know, summer traffic.
Yes.
I think all the kids coming in.
Yeah.
Rock of Ages did really well this week, selling 95%, awesome. Which is good, but also I have to say they have like this huge handicap because they're at the Helen Hayes, which it shouldn't be difficult to sell 95% of the Helen Hayes, so whatever. And
although oddly enough, Tiffany was there this week. Pop singer Tiffany.
Oh yeah.
Yes, and I'm actually
maybe
going,
that's why it's 95%.
Right, because she was there. I'm actually going to see her and Debbie Gibson in concert tomorrow night.
Cool.
I'm very excited about that.
That'll be an awesome blast for the past night.
Yes, it will be. 80s
fun with that. And a Book of Mormon is selling its absolute capacity, which I figured out now this is the most it can possibly sell, 102.4% of its tickets. So that's obviously some standing room in there. And also their average ticket price for last week was $143. That is crazy.
Crazy.
Crazy. My gosh. So congratulations to you, Book of Mormon. I mean, you're worth it. You're worth it.
Haven't seen it yet, no. Sorry.
Oh, that is so good.
I've heard good things about it.
I'm lucky enough to have seen it, thank God.
I know Rory O'Malley is in it, who I've interviewed before.
Yeah,
it's amazing.
Me too. I love
so
Rory.
Nice.
Yeah.
So great.
Well, Adam, thank you so much for coming to
Stagers
TV
Jesse.
This week.
I loved it.
The website is Adaumbelle's Quest for to fill your Broadway needs, but also your off-Broadway needs and your cabaret needs around the city. This is the website to go to. Check it out. I'm so glad you could be here.
I'm so glad you asked me. It was wonderful.
Have a great week at the theater.
Have a great week, Stage Rushers.